This is the story of the course.
Jesus was a man just like us who lived about 2,000 years ago in Israel. Well, we say he was a man just like us, and so does the Bible. But he did some pretty amazing things. Just a few from the list are making sick people better, feeding 5,000 people with just a few fish and rolls, and calming storms. He did many amazing things, and we call them miracles. Of course, doing all these amazing things made Jesus pretty popular. He got up quite a following, and one day it got so big that people lined the streets, waved palm branches, and shouted, "Hosanna!" which means praise, have joy, jump up and down, because the man we most admire is here. This got the attention of the leaders of the people. So you might ask, how was Jesus like me? I can't do miracles. I don't get crowds of people wanting to see me. I don't have the attention of the leaders of the people. That might be true. What the Bible means is that Jesus went through a lot of the things we do in our lives. It wasn't all fame, praise, and walking on water. Yep, did that too. Remember the leaders of the people? They didn't like the way Jesus was getting so popular. They were afraid that if it carried on, the people would listen more to Jesus than to them. They didn't want to lose power. So they persuaded Judas, one of Jesus' closest friends, to say that he was plotting to do bad stuff. This wasn't true, but they needed to find a way to get at Jesus. They offered Judas money, and he took it. Money was more important to Judas than Jesus was. Jesus knew that something bad was going to happen, and he told the rest of his friends about it. They all promised to stick by him no matter what. One friend, Peter, was particularly upset when Jesus said he would let him down. Then they all went to a garden to pray about the things which were going to happen. Jesus asked his friends to watch out for people coming into the garden. He wanted to spend some quiet time with his Father God, and he knew danger was ahead. But all his friends fell asleep. In fact, he woke them up, and they fell asleep again, 3 times. While they were in the garden, some soldiers came with a crowd to arrest Jesus. Remember Judas? He showed the soldiers which man was Jesus. When his friends saw Jesus being arrested, they all ran away. And how Peter was upset when Jesus suggested he would let him down. What do you think he did? Later on, when people asked if Peter knew Jesus, Peter was scared to admit he did. He didn't want to be associated with a criminal. He wanted to look good in front of people. Just like us, there were people in Jesus' life who should have done the right thing when they had the chance. People such as teachers, soldiers, and church leaders. But the teachers and church leaders were jealous of how much the people loved Jesus. They saw him as a threat. They found more people who would lie about him and make up stories. But surely the guards and soldiers would realise this. Well, they did. But they were too scared to go against the teachers and church leaders because in those days, they were powerful. Remember the crowds who shouted Hosanna? When Jesus went to court, they gathered around to watch. The judge asked the crowd what he should do with Jesus. They all shouted, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" The very same people who just 1 week earlier were his biggest fans. The judge handed Jesus over to the soldiers. But these weren't like our police who have to follow the law. They were mean and nasty. They took his clothes, beat him up, and put a crown of thorns on his head. They gave him horrible stuff to drink. They spat on him and they made fun of him in nasty ways. In those days, criminals were not just punished by prison or fines. They were killed by hanging on a cross. Jesus was hung next to two other criminals and treated the same way, even though he had done nothing wrong. The crowds and soldiers continued to make fun of him. They mocked his faith in God and said that God should rescue him. Only a few of his friends stood at the back and watched. You would think that having all these things happen to him would make Jesus angry or fall out with his friends. You can see why it would have been easy for him to hit back at the soldiers or try to tell the judge things about other people. But he didn't. Despite everything that was happening to him, he was quiet, respectful, and even comforted one of the other criminals who was dying with him. When it came time for him to die, he asked God to forgive all the people that had hurt him. You might be thinking, this is a pretty miserable story. You might be struggling to see why Christians say Easter is a brilliant thing to celebrate. But all these bad things happened to show us that Jesus didn't have an easy time of it. He went through all sorts of stuff to show us that he had things happen to him. That in those ways, he was just like us. But the story doesn't end there. Remember the miracles? 3 days after Jesus died, God performed the biggest miracle of all time. He brought Jesus back from the dead. So, Jesus is different from us after all. No, but this is where the story flips and becomes about us being like Jesus. The Bible tells us that Jesus was the first person to beat death, but he won't be the last. We can all do this. When we do things that are not good, or we don't do things God's way, or we respond badly to things that happen, we are doing what the Bible calls sin. God is perfect, and he can't be alongside people who sin, even though he still loves them very much. It's like the sin builds a wall between the person and God. And this means that when those people die, they can't go to live with God. Jesus is perfect too. He never did anything wrong while he lived on earth, despite everything that happened to him. So there was nothing that could keep him from being with God. When he died on the cross, he took the punishment for everyone's sins. He asked God to forgive everyone. This means that if we accept what Jesus did, if we ask God to forgive us, say thank you to Jesus and promise to do things his way, we too can be friends with God. We can be friends right now and then live with him forever after we die. We can be just like Jesus. But what about all the miracles and stuff? Surely that's where we're still different to Jesus. Nope. After he came back to life, Jesus went to live with God in heaven. But he sent his Holy Spirit to live with us. This is the part of God which gives us power to live like Jesus did. It means we can respond to things that happen to us just like Jesus did. It means we can see miracles just like Jesus did. It means we can have a great relationship with God before and after we die. We really can be just like Jesus. If you would like to put things right with God and have a life full of his Spirit, here is a prayer you can say. God, I know that you made me and want me to obey you with all my heart. I know I have thought and done things against your directions. I am sorry. Jesus, I know that you gave up your life to save me from these sins and bring me back into God's plan. Thank you for what you have done. I accept your promises and will do my best to do things your way from now on. Holy Spirit, please come and help me live my best life for God, Jesus, and those around me. Amen. This is the story of the cross. The Father loved us so much that when we did our very worst, Jesus gave his very best, and he died for us.